I'm Christine Helms, Associate Professor of Physics at the University of Richmond, and I'm going to tell you how to throw a perfect spiral. The steps to throwing a perfect spiral start first with transitioning the ball into your hand and getting a nice grip on the ball. Next, you have to get your feet set so that you can step into your throw, rotate your torso so that you get a lot of force and momentum behind the ball for the release. And then last, the release of the ball where your fingers apply a torque, causing the ball to spiral and stay on track as it travels downfield. The most important thing to throwing a great spiral is the grip on the ball. In the case of a football, the center of rotation is the middle of the ball, and the quarterback uses their fingers when they grip the ball to apply a torque to the outer edge of the ball, causing it to spin. And the laces on the ball can help with that. It helps the quarterback figure out where exactly to align their hand on the ball, as well as provides a little extra traction to imparting that spin. Why throw a spiral? Introductory physics will tell you if you launch the ball at a 45-degree angle, it's going to travel the furthest it can downfield. A football, because of its unique shape, when hit with air resistance, can cause it to wobble. Similar to how a top spins and stays upright, a football will stay in the direction it's moving much longer if you have it spinning than if you don't have it spinning. We focus a lot on the arm movement and the grip, but in reality, to get a lot of strength behind your throw, you have to use your legs, your quadriceps, as well as your abdominals as you rotate to get a lot of force so that you can launch the ball far enough downfield. And that's how you throw the perfect spiral.